Good morning, students. Today I am going to teach class 9 students subject English lesson 2. In lesson 2 you will read about the sound of music. Students, in this lesson there are two parts. Today I am going to teach you the first part. Evelyn Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. It means here the main character is Evelyn Glennie. Evelyn Glennie is the main character in this story. And she listens to sound without hearing it. Without hearing means she was a deaf. She was not able to hear. She was a deaf. A deaf child. So students, it is a very interesting chapter. How a deaf child is able to listen to the sound and how she becomes a great musician. So we will start now. Ross hour crowds jostle for position on the underground train platform. Underground train platform. As you know, there is metro, underground metro. So in the same way, there was underground train platform, and on that platform there were so many people. It was the rush hour. There was a large crowd, there was a huge crowd on the platform. A slight girl, slight means small, lean and thin girl. A lean and thin girl looking younger than her 17 years. So Evelyn Glennie, what was her age? 17 years. But she looked younger. She looked younger. Younger than her 17 years. She looked younger and she was nervous. Yet excited as she felt the vibration of the approaching train. She felt that the train was coming. So when she felt that the train was coming, she was very excited, but she was nervous. Both, she was nervous and excited. She was happy, but she was nervous. Okay, she was standing on the platform of an underground train. So what happened then? It was her first day at the prestigious Royal Academy of Music in London. Royal Academy of Music. Where was this Royal Academy? In London. In London. So she was going, Evelyn was going to attend the Royal Academy of Music. Evelyn Glennie was going to London. That's why she was standing on the platform. She was standing on the platform because she wanted to catch the train so that she would reach the Royal Academy of Music, which was situated in London. So if the question comes, where was the Royal Academy of Music? The Royal Academy of Music was situated in London. Okay? It is clear? So it was the first time. It was the first time she was going to attend the Royal Academy of Music. That's why she was nervous. And daunting enough. She was frightening enough for any teenager phrase from a Scottish farm. She was from a Scottish farm. She was from Scotland. She was from a countryside. So when a countryside girl, when a village girl goes to town to take part in a grand ceremony or to take part in any royal academy, then obviously that one feels very nervous. So it was the reason Evelyn Glennie was feeling nervous, because for the first time she was going to attend the Royal Academy of Music, and it was a very well-known institute. It was a very famous institute in London. But this aspiring musician faced a bigger challenge than most. She was profoundly deaf. No doubt, everybody faces challenges. Everybody faces problems. Everybody feels nervous when for the first time one goes to attend any institute. But she was more nervous because she was a deaf child. She was not able to hear. It was the problem with her. That's why it was the reason she was more nervous in comparison to the other people, other children. Evelyn Glennie's loss of her hearing had been gradual. It means she lost her hearing capacity. She lost her hearing ability gradually, not suddenly, not all of a sudden, not dramatically. Slowly and slowly, she started losing her hearing capacity. Her mother remembers noticing something was wrong when she was 8 years old. It means at 8, when Evelyn Glennie was only 8 years old, for the first time, her mother noticed that, her mother realized that there was something, there was a problem with her. She was able to notice, she was able to realize. Old Evelyn, what was she doing at that time? She was waiting to play the piano. When Evelyn was waiting to play the piano, at that time, her mother realized that there was something problem with her. I suddenly realized she had not heard, says Isabel Glennie. So who was her mother? Isabel Glennie. Isabel Glennie was mother of Evelyn Glennie. So for the first time, at the age of 8, Isabel Glennie, mother of Evelyn Glennie, noticed that and noticed this thing, that she had some problem. She had some hearing problem. But for quite a while, Evelyn managed to conceal. Conceal means hide. But somehow or other, Evelyn did not want to expose this thing. Evelyn decided to hide this thing, and she was able to conceal this for some time. But what happens? She tries her level best to conceal this from her teacher, from her friends. But by the time she was 11, at the 8, her mother realized that she had some problem. But at 11, it was impossible for her to conceal it. It was impossible for her to conceal this. So this time, when she was 11 years old, her marks had deteriorated. Her marks got worse and worse. And her headmistress urged her parents to take her to a specialist. when her performance got worse and worse, when she was not doing better in her performance, her headmistress realized that she had some problem. And she suggested, her headmistress suggested her parents to consult a specialist so that she would be treated well. It was then discovered that her hearing was severely impaired as a result of gradual nerve damage. So students, it was the turning point. If at the age of 8, she had been treated by a specialist, the result would have been different. Maybe she would not have been the deaf, the complete deaf. But due to her mistake, she tried her level best to conceal it. And due to this concealment, her weakness started getting worse and worse. So they were advised that she should be fitted with hearing aids and sent to a school for that day. So the specialist, the doctor, suggested her parents to arrange a machine for her ear, and she should be sent to a deep school. Means Evelyn Glennie was suggested to attend a special school, not the common school, as you are the students of common schools, usual schools. But she was suggested to attend a special school that was fit for the deep school. Everything suddenly looked black, says Evelyn. It was beyond expectation. Evelyn Glennie had never expected that she would have to go to a special school in her life. She could not face the hard realities of life. It was beyond expectation for her. But Evelyn was not going to give up. But she had strong determination. She was not like a common child. She was determined to lead a normal life and pursue her interest in music. She was interested in music. Doctor suggested her not to learn music. The doctor suggested her that it was impossible for her to learn music, especially for a deaf child. And you will have to attend a deep school. But Evelyn was not ready to accept it. Evelyn was determined to learn music. Evelyn was determined to lead a normal life just like the common children by attending a common school. So what happens? Most of the teachers discouraged her when she decided to learn music, mostly teachers discouraged her. Mostly teachers suggested her not to do that. But percussionist Ron Forbes was a percussionist. What is percussionist? Percussionist was a person who plays drum, the tabla, etc. So Ron Forbes was a percussionist, spotted her potential, saw her talents. Ron Forbes realized the potential, the talents of Evelyn. He realized. He began by tuning two large drums. So he took a test. He gave two tunes to different notes. And he suggested Evelyn not to hear through your ears, and he suggested her to sense it, to realize it in some other ways. Students, generally, when your teachers teach something, when your musical teacher teaches something, first, what we do? We listen by using our ears. And she was not able to listen. She was not able to hear. So Ron Forbes suggested her to realize it in a different way, not like the common child. And she tried. Suddenly I realized it was the statement, it was the statement of Evelyn. Suddenly I realized I could feel the higher drum from the waist up. From the waist up. Upper part of the body. By using the upper part of the body, she realized. She realized the higher drum sound at the upper part of the body, from the waist up, and the lower drum sound at the lower part of the body, means waist down. From waist down, she realized the lower tone, and from the waist up, she realized the higher tone. Forbes repeated the exercise, and soon Evelyn discovered that she could sense certain notes in different parts of the body. When it was revised again and again, when it was repeated under the guidance of Ron Forbes, Evelyn started realizing each music through her, each and every part of her body. Through her body, she realized the sound. I had learned to open my mind and body to sounds and vibration. Through the vibration, through the realization, she understood the sound. She realized the sound. The rest was sheer determination and hard work. No doubt, she did the hard work. Due to her hard work, due to her strong determination, due to her practice, she achieved her target. She reached at her goal. She never looked back from that point onwards. She toured the United Kingdom with a youth orchestra. Orchestra means a group of musical players. And by the time she was 16, at the age of 16, she toured so many countries to take part in orchestra. With a group of musicians, she toured so many countries to take part. The concerts. She auditioned for the Royal Academy of Music and scored one of the highest marks in the history of the academy. When she went to the Royal Academy, yes, this one, when she went to the Royal Academy of Music, she scored the one of the highest marks and she created the history in that academy. By achieving the highest score, she gradually moved from the orchestral work to solo performance. Not only she was taking part in the group, along with the group musicians, she also performed alone. Solo means alone. She gave solo performance along with orchestra, along with group song, she also performed solo. At the end of her 3-year course, she had captured most of the top awards. She achieved so many awards. She got 3-year degree course. She learned 3 years. And then after, she reached at the pinnacle point of her life. And for all this, Evelyn won't accept any hint of heroic achievement. If you work hard and know where you are going, you will get there. It was the statement of Evelyn. You must fix the aim. You should do hard labor and you should have strong determination. Target, determination, hard work. When all these three things come together, then your achievement, your reaching goal will be easier. And she got right to the top. The world's most sought after multi-percussionist with a mastery of some 1,000 instruments and hectic international schedule. She became busy in her world schedule, world programs. She was not limited to a particular state and country. She toured the whole world. It is intriguing to watch Evelyn function to effortlessly without hearing. Without hearing, she performed well. In our two-hour discussion, she never missed a word. Men with bushy beards give me trouble. Yes, it was her own opinion. When any singer having bushy beard, jinka jyada dadhi rehta hai, so she gave her trouble. Why? She laughed. It is not just watching the lips. It is the whole face, especially the eyes. She speaks flawlessly without making any mistake with a Scottish lit. Lit means a way of speaking. My speech is clear because I could hear till I was 11. So it was the positive point. Because she became deaf gradually. Not dramatically, not suddenly. And it was the plus point with her. But that does not explain how she managed to learn French and master a basic Japanese. Other language, other country's language also she learned. As for music, she explains, it pours in through every part of my body. So she realized the music in each and every part of her body. Though she was not able to hear, but she was able to realize. It tingles in the skin. It causes sensation in the skin, my cheekbones and even in my hair. She can sense the sound passing up the stick into her fingertips, but leaning against the drums, she can feel the resonance flowing into her body. On a wooden platform, she removes her shoes so that the vibration passes through her bare feet and upper legs. When she was giving the performance, when she was playing the music, she was not using any kind of shoes. She was with her bare foot so that she would realize, she would sense the sound of the music. Not surprisingly, Evelyn delights her audience. All her audience, all the spectators, all the audience were delighted, were happy at her performance. In 1991, she was presented with the Royal Philharmonic Society's prestigious Soloist of the Year Award. She was awarded with Philharmonic means Sangeet Premi Society's prestigious Soloist, means for a single person, of the year award. Says master percussionist James Blades, God may have taken her hearing, but he has given her back something extraordinary. It was the statement of a famous percussionist whose name was James Blades. James Blades was another percussionist who was her guide, who was that percussionist, Ron Forbes. And according to John Blades, God has snatched her hearing power, but God has given her an extraordinary thing. And only the extraordinary persons get such type of extraordinary things. Only the extraordinary persons get some extraordinary blessings from God. Special blessing from God. What we hear, she feels. We hear the sounds, but she feels the sound. It was the difference between a common man and Evelyn Glenn. Her hearing, but he has given, yes. Evelyn confesses that she is something of a workaholic. Workaholic means always her desire is to work more and more and more. She never felt tired of work. She never felt boring due to work. She had hunger for work. She was always hungry for work. She expected more and more work. Often harder than classical musicians. But the rewards are enormous. She had got enormous rewards. Apart from the regular concerts, Evelyn also gives free concerts. She always gave free concerts in prisons, in hospitals. Because her only motive was not to earn money. She was not running after money. She also gave some performance without getting money. Means free concerts. And especially in medical hospitals and in prisons. She also gives high priority to classes for young musicians. She also trained the young musicians. And Richlin of the Beethoven Fund for Deaf Children says she is a shining inspiration for deaf children. And really, she was a shining inspiration. Mostly deaf children were inspired due to Evelyn Glennie. They see that there is nowhere that they cannot go. So the deaf children got their confidence. Remembering the effort, remembering the performance, remembering the result of Evelyn Glennie. So Evelyn Glennie became the inspiration for thousands and millions of deaf children. So students, really, it is a great lesson. Evelyn Glennie has already accomplished, means got more than most people twice her age. Nobody would get so many achievements what Evelyn got in a limited time. She has brought percussion to the front of the orchestra and given inspiration to those who are handicapped. People who look to her and say, if she can do it, I can. And not the least, she has given enormous pleasure to millions. And students, really, she became inspiration for millions and millions of deaf children. So it is all about Evelyn Glennie listens to sound without hearing it. It is a very interesting topic. So students, I hope you will enjoy it. And my next class, I will teach the part 2. Thank you.